For this setup, we will be using the Siglent oscilloscope and a function generator. We will also be using a decade resistor box set to 100 ohms. The 100 ohm switch should be up, and all the other switches should be down. We use the two green posts, which are connected to either side of the resistor. The black post, which in this case is covered over with red tape, is never used in the experiments we do in this lab. We will also be using a decade capacitor box. We will set it to 0.1 microfarads. The decade boxes are all just a little different, so you have to look at your particular one to see how to set it. We will need to use a binding post to BNC adapter, or in other words, a coaxial to banana plug adapter. Attach one to each of the oscilloscope inputs. Remember to push and turn. A loose adapter can cause a bad signal. We are also going to attach an adapter to the output of the function generator. We are going to hook up the following circuit, which includes the resistor, the capacitor, and the function generator. Then we're going to take measurements of that circuit using the oscilloscope. The ground for the function generator is right here. The ground for the oscilloscope is right here. When I plug the oscilloscope and the function generator into the same outlet, it causes them to be internally grounded. This means they have the same ground. But our circuit requires the function generator and oscilloscope to have different grounds. Fortunately, we have a fix for that. For this, we use a 3-prong to 2-prong converter. This keeps the ground wire for one of the devices from being plugged into the outlet. Take the plug for the function generator, put the 3-prong to 2-prong adapter on, and then plug it into the outlet. Go ahead and plug the oscilloscope in too, without an adapter. The first wire that we're going to hook up is the wire connecting the black post on the function generator to the right side of the resistor. So, now I will connect the black post on the function generator to the right side of the resistor. Next, we're going to hook up the wire between the left side of the resistor and the right side of the capacitor. So here I am hooking up the left side of the resistor. Note that it's the middle post on the decade box. And then the other end to the right side of the capacitor. Now we are going to connect the left side of the capacitor to the red post on the function generator. So here I'm connecting the left side of the capacitor and the other end to the red post on the function generator. If you trace the wires, you should be able to see the loop of the circuit. We go around from the function generator to the resistor to the capacitor, and then the capacitor back to the function generator. The RC circuit with the function generator, resistor, and capacitor is now set up. But we still need to hook up the oscilloscope to make measurements. The oscilloscope is really just a fancy voltmeter. And I find it easier to hook up my voltmeters after I've set up the rest of my circuit. We need to attach the oscilloscope ground wire to the point in between the capacitor and the resistor. Here's the wire connecting the left side of the resistor to the right side of the capacitor. I can connect my ground wire either to the post on the left side of the resistor or to the post on the right side of the capacitor. I'm going to choose to plug it into the post on the left side of the resistor. I can plug the other end of the wire into either of the black posts on the oscilloscope. The oscilloscope is internally grounded. This means that once I've hooked part of my circuit to the ground on one of the channels, then that becomes the ground on the other channel as well. The left side of the capacitor needs to be connected to the red post on channel 1 of the oscilloscope. So here I will connect the left side of the capacitor to the red post on channel 1. Finally, we need to connect the right side of the resistor to the red post on channel 2 of the oscilloscope. So, here I connect the right side of the resistor to the red post on channel 2 of the oscilloscope. Our circuit is now hooked up to the oscilloscope, and we're ready to start taking measurements.